Hello, it's Jang here with a look at a small LEGO Legends of Chima set for 2015, a little battle pack or troop builder. This is the Sabre-Tooth Tiger pack, and officially this comes with 74 pieces. The named exclusive character in this set is over on the left. That is General Syrox, or Syrox, S-I-R-O-X, with his sand blue colored head with some fur detail on there. He's got the long teeth as well. The other two characters are not given specific names. They're just general warriors, not general, but normal, you know, average warriors. Massable units intended to be swapped around with different pieces as you like. I'm generally not a big fan of the stud shooters, but I feel like they've made a nice compound weapon, you know, an assembly using a stud shooter over here. This is called a Snowzooka. You can see it kind of looks like just a rocket launcher, and I think that's done really well. It's got a good size to it, good proportions, and I think it has good balance for these figures. Take a look at the figures from behind so you can see what is common, what is not. And there's everything fully exposed, so you can see the two of them having the alternate faces, such as they are, all covered with bandages. And there are the main face prints. Set comes with a stylized disc launcher weapon emplacement, and unlike most of the other ones, this one doesn't have any kind of eye detail. It's not trying to look like an entire animal, it's just trying to have the inspiration of the saber-tooth tribe. This one's on skis to make it easier to actually move around, which makes a lot of sense with the way that the ice tribes are on the move in the actual stories. And this is your activator back here to launch the thing, so you can angle it however you want to get a shorter shot or a longer shot. Push that and out comes the disc. I kind of messed that up a little bit, but this is what the discs look like. You get three of them with the set, and these on the sides are just little simple assemblies just to give you a little extra texture and bring in a little bit more depth to the whole scene. Last but not least is this Sabretooth Tribe banner, which is looking ratty around the bottom as it's supposed to. And this is just something to kind of mark your territory and give kind of a rallying point for your troops. It's a plastic piece and it's just held up at the top with a long weapon, and that does it for the components of this set. These sets are small and cheap, but I think that they give you a good value for your buck. Out of the different ones that were released this season, this is definitely one of the ones that I like the most. I especially like the figures, the variety of figures, and the differences that they have relative to the figures that have been included in the larger sets. So I feel like this has a lot of extra value. If you're not able to afford or don't want to spend a lot of money on one of the bigger sets, you can still get some really cool minifigures to play with and to display with this small cheap set. That does it for my look at this set. I hope I showed you everything that you wanted to see about it. If you have any thoughts you would like to share regarding this set, please do down in the comment section on the video. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video, and I hope that you'll stick around for more, because more are on the way soon.